Good afternoon, guys. My name is Kenny, and you're watching Brave the Wilds on YouTube. So I had another round of yard sale finds, but this was not a yard sale this time. This was Craigslist. And what you see is what you get. We've got three items here. Two of them are mine. One of them is sort of mine. The first one, as you can see, is a Coleman liquid fuel camp stove. And the price on that, if you can't see, was $10. I got a double bit axe head. I haven't looked at it too hard yet. I don't know if it has a brand on it or not, but you can see the price tag on that, $3. And I've got a bench vise here as well, and this one is a woodworking vise. That is $10 if you can't see the label on that. So total is $23. And once I tell you a little bit more about these things, I think you'll see that that was a really good price for all of this stuff. So let me bring the camera closer and we'll go over each item individually, and I'll show you what I see about them, and hopefully we'll get them cleaned up and get them used in the field very soon. So to start off with, this Coleman stove here I paid $10 for, as you can see on the price tag, and I'm not sure the model year on this, I'm not sure when it is made. Coleman generally puts on here somewhere when it was made, but I haven't looked very hard right now. It is a 413H. It was made in Wichita, Kansas, United States. So it says that on the front. And then I don't believe I see any other markings on it besides that. But this is a very common stove. These have been around for quite a long time. These have been around since, you know, before the propane. And so the way it works is you've got your grate here, as always. You've got windscreens which pop into these holes on the side. And there are actually two holes for the windscreens. And this is a much deeper stove compared to the propane stove. If you guys look at the last yard sale jackpot video I did, I got a propane stove, and that one is probably in worse shape in terms of the looks, aesthetically, but in terms of functionality, it worked fine right off the bat. This one, however, is going to need some work, even though it might be cosmetically in better shape, only some very small spots of rust. It will take a little bit of work, but I'll tell you what, if you give me 400 likes on this video, I'll do a restoration on this stove and I'll film it. So go ahead and go down right now and click the like button, and if I get 400 likes on this video, I'll do a restoration on this. The next item, as you can see, a double bit axe head. The handle's been broken off of it, and you can see the price tag right there, $3. Take that off. It's a fairly thin profile, but I do see a difference in taper on either side, which hints that it is a quality brand. It may not have a brand at all like the other double bit, or it may have a brand once I start taking some of the rust off. We'll have to see. But I do see how this side is tapered, and it is a little bit longer and a little bit thinner, and this side is a little bit shorter and a little bit fatter. It also has these teeth marks cut out in it. Sorry, I'm moving it around a lot. It's got these teeth marks right here, which you can see. You can hear it. That's not, I don't think that was accidental. I think that was intentional for sure. So maybe that clues in on what the brand is. I'm not sure, but anyway, nonetheless, it is in really good shape. The edges are hardly worn at all. They just look a little bit, you know, the whole thing has a light surface rust, but I don't see any serious pitting on this side. There is a little bit more pitting on this side, but as far as the edge, it doesn't have a nick in it at all. So I'm thinking this might be a really quality piece. So the last item is a B&G bench vise, and this is a woodworking vise. The only reason we got this is because when I was going, my dad and I were going to look at the stove, we saw this also for sale. And so, taking a look at it, it says right on the front, the model and the brand, if you can see, it says B&G, and it's a 500V. I looked this up on eBay, and it's probably worth about $40 to $60 as it sits, and restored, it could easily bring $100. And you can see, if if I can get the price tag off here. Maybe not. You can see what we paid for it, $10. So, of course, since my dad's more the woodworker, I offered it, asked him if he wanted to buy it before I said I was gonna buy it, and he did, so it's not really mine, but like I said, he's more of a woodworker than I am, so pretty cool. Hopefully he'll restore it nicely and won't just leave it in the shape it's in, because if it was mine, I would restore it, but hopefully he'll clean it up and it'll make it look good. And we'll put it to use. So that's item number 3. Guys, I appreciate you watching today. If you liked the video, go ahead and hit the like. Like I said, if you get 400 likes on this video, if we all get 400 likes on it, I'll do a restoration on the Coleman stove. But besides that, I'll keep you updated on anything I find in the future. I think it's a lot of fun to go out and find these vintage items that are, you know, good quality. I mean, really good quality for, you know, sometimes dirt cheap prices. Like this vise right here, I'd consider that dirt cheap for what it's worth, especially since it's probably higher quality than 90% of the things on the market today, with everything being made in China. And $10 is really hard to beat. So, like I said, hope you enjoyed. Go ahead and hit the like button if you want to. And until the next video, y'all take care.